demonstrate the basic most important technique of using the space healer effectively. The key to the success of the use of the space healer is to determine, to first find the ouch point, or we call the trigger point of pain. It's very important to find this, locate the point of pain first. Generally, patient will just describe a general area of pain, and of course, sometimes they'll be able to tell you exactly where they hurt. But still, you have to confirm it first. To confirm this kind of ouch point, you really have to probe very hard into the area, like this. You know, sometimes with just an index finger, but more often, I will use a thumb to kind of go into it and really determine where the ouch point, where the really trigger point of pain is. Because a lot of chronic pain involve a very deep-seated ligament, not superficial muscle or the skin area. Usually it's deep inside. So in order to reach the area, you really need to probe in and find the point of pain. Let's say, you know, we find out this is the area that it hurt most, okay? Once you determine the point of pain, usually I will do a few. You know, I will explore the whole area and you know, mentally know where the points are. And you start with the most painful spot. Let's say this is the most painful spot. You determine ouch point, and then you start with the treatment. First of all, you turn on the device. Alright, or if you're not sure what the setting has been in the past, you reset the device first. To reset the device, you hold down the mode button, alright, hold it down, and then simultaneously give this on button one push. And then you let go of the mode button. Now, not together, not just like this together. A lot of people make the mistake. They just kind of push these two together. And sometimes it's reset, sometimes it doesn't. So the key is to you hold down the mode button first, all right? While holding down the mode button and give this on button one push, and then you let go of the mode button. That is the way to reset. Reset means whatever is in the computer, storage, the power, the mode setting will be clear. The power will be returned to zero. So this way you can be sure the device is back to zero. Find the point of pain, probe into it, then you turn on the power gradually, all right? Good contact first. And then you turn on the power until the person says enough. The higher the better, all right? Let's say this is enough. Then you hold the device there for about half a minute or so that the person get used to the, you know, the power setting. And then you can turn on the AM and FM mode. We do that usually for a pointed treatment. We try to do AM and FM together. This will make the treatment more dynamic. Because the AM gives you the amplitude modification, the FM gives you the frequency change. So this will make the treatment more dynamic. So to turn on the AM, use the mode button to bring on the light of the AM, and while the light is still on, you push the plus button to lock it in. You have 3 seconds to do that. So if you leave the light on, if you don't do the push, the plus button quick enough, in 3 seconds the light will go off. Now, when you try to do the push button, plus button without the light on, you are just increasing the power. You're not actually turning on the mode. So the important thing is that bring on the mode button quickly, push the plus button while the light is still on. That way you turn on the mode. FM mode, similarly, you bring the light on first and then push the plus button. Now in this way, you can turn on both AM and FM mode simultaneously. So both of them are operating simultaneously. You can actually turn on all four modes simultaneously, but it's not necessary. But this is the most commonly used way, is to use the AM and FM on pointed treatment. Okay, once this is turned on, you kind of put the device there, hold it there firmly, or you can rub into the area, massage the joint, you know, the deep ligament. Remember, we're trying to treat the deep-seated ligament. And then after a while, after a minute or so, and you can have the person move the joint, you know, move the shoulder, you know, upward, you know, back way, or forward, all right, or just rotate the shoulder. And this way, you have a chance to cover all the proprioceptor nerve endings in this area. This way, you'll have a better result. Okay, so this is the basic technique to treat the point area, the ouch point. Okay, the key to success is to find the point, the ouch point, treat it like this for a couple of minutes. It then may involve a few points. So if you finish with one point, you can move on to the other point, all right, like this. Or you can turn down the power first before you transfer the device from one spot to another, because as you leave the skin, it's become more irritating, you know, when you kind of, you know, change location. But of course, after the person gets used to it, you don't have to, you know, just do it. You know, it saves you some time. Alright? So you do one point, you know, after a couple of minutes, all right, this is done, then you move on to another point like this. Okay? So these are the very common shoulder point area, like this. Okay? A couple of minutes here, a couple of minutes here. Right. So after you've done all the point treatment, then you want to do a sweeping change, sweeping treatment, like this. All right? Now, usually with the sweeping mode of treatment, we use the basic mode first, rather than AMFM, because AMFM, sometimes the power fluctuates. So we want to go back to the basic mode. Well, one way to do that is to turn it off. Bring on the light, minus it. Okay, I'll show you again. So you want to turn off the FM, you bring on the light of the FM and minus button to turn it off. Okay, and AM, you bring on the AM light and then push the minus button while the light is still on. That way you turn on both modes, but the power is still the same. Right? So you have the basic mode of operation. That means back to just the basic of 60 Hz, and you go like this. Right. Now, as you do this, you will experience a different area of stickiness. Say, let's say this is a sticky area, right, compared to the other area, it's not so sticky. Usually it means this, the sticky area is a problem area. That means you have to treat this area a little bit longer. Right. You might want to go back to the pointed treatment, or you can just treat it a little bit, you know, just work on it a little bit longer, a couple more minutes. Let's say, after you've done it for a couple of minutes, and you still find this area rather sticky, the stickiness not going away. So what do? You can then try different frequency. Now on FM mode, on the F mode, you have a four fixed frequency. You can bring on to the higher frequency, all right? This way, you can hear the sound is a little bit different. All right, now let me go back to the lower frequency. Lower frequency. So it's a different kind of tone, all right? High frequency, you bring on the FM and you press it, so you have the high. All right, so this way you are using a different frequency to go through the same area, and oftentimes the stickiness will go away, all right? So these are the two basic ways of using the space healer, the pointer treatment with AM-FM mode, or the sweeping treatment with the fixed frequency. Okay, now as I said, the key to success, at least with the pain management area, is you must find the point of pain, the trigger point of pain. All right, it could be anywhere, but oftentimes you'll be guided by the patient or the person who's being treated. You know, they may show you a different point of pain, or sometimes they may be able to pinpoint the area. Right, but still, just don't take their word for, you know, you have to try it yourself. You have to really confirm it. Now, let's say the person complained about the neck problem or the shoulder problem. Oftentimes, they come together. Our experience shows the pain could be right in the base of the hairline or the occipital area. The way to find that is really probe it, you know, use a thumb to really to find it, all right, to elicit, we call it the ouch point. And sometimes, you know, you'll feel it's a lump there underneath the area, and that could be a painful area. But still, try to confirm it, pushing it. And the person say, ouch, then you know that is a point. So for the neck area, oftentimes, you know, in at the hairline level, the occipital level, or on both sides of the neck. And it could be down here, you know, the bony prominence, the C7 area on both sides. Right, this is where the tension tend to concentrate, and it could be anywhere along the shoulder. Right, you find it, look for it, or it could be at the corner of the scapula, the shoulder blade, or on the inner angle, inner edge of the scapula. And oftentimes, you know, with gallbladder pain, you may have a referred pain in this area. So, just look for it. Okay, just look for it. The back problem, it could be anywhere on each side, all right? About an inch and a half where the paravertebral muscles are. Look for them. And then in the back pain, it could be somewhere here. Let me show you how to look for it. You put your thumb, you know, your hand on the crest of the pelvic, and then the thumb usually will point to the problem area. It could be right in the middle, all right, anywhere in the middle, or down here, or it could be on this side, all right. This is where the SI joints are located, you know, right, you know, at the inner angle, inner side of the SI joint, sacroiliac joint. All right, for a female, usually the pain could be down in the sacrum area, you know, lower down on both sides. Right, so look for it, you know, determine the ouch point. And sometimes people complain, you know, this gluteal minimus muscle will be kind of sore, tender, or it could be the kidney area, all right? And this is where you try to look for it. Okay, look for the pain first, look for the pain first, before you go and treat it. Now, low back pain often is this area. You can just put it here, all right? And then you turn on the device, or turn on the power to the maximum the person can take, and then you go AM and FM together, all right? And then you hold the device there, or you can rub into the device, or sometimes you can ask the person to bend, all right? Bend forward, backward, or even sideways, go sideways, all right? Why the device is applied, or even rotation, just rotate the joint, all right? This will be another way of doing it. Okay, good. For headache, oftentimes people can tell you the pain is right on the side, like the temple area, all right? Again, look for it first. Use a finger or the thumb, you know, to try to elicit the pain. So if that's where the pain is located, the ouch point, then you put the device there. Now with the head area, you don't need to turn the power very high because it's more sensitive area. And it could be somewhere, you know, between the eyebrow or up here or even here. All right, wherever you find the pain, you apply the device there. For TMJ, the jaw problems, you know, oftentimes people feel the pain in the face, then it could be right here. All right, again, determine the point of pain. Once you determine the point of pain, you apply the device here. All right, for earache, sometimes it could be behind the ear. Okay, just sweep around the area or right in the front. There are three meridian points right in this area. Just push it over here. Okay, sometimes people have sore throat, you know, lymphatic tonsils enlarged, or you have the swollen gland. They just put it under the jaw area. Okay, or it could be sore throat right over here. Or here, or here, and sometimes with the thyroid, you place it right over the thyroid gland on each side, you know, a couple of minutes here, 2 or 3 minutes on each side. Right. Now, at times people complain about the pain in the chest, thinking it may be a heart problem, and some of them may have been to the hospital investigating the possibility of a heart problem, and they couldn't find anything, you know, with the heart. And our experience shows it could be the problem between the rib and the sternum, the joint, the costal chondral joint area. And again, most importantly, elicit the point of pain. All right, they will be ouch. They will tell you that's where they hurt or where the rib hurt. And then you again similarly, you place it over the joint area, turn on the device to the maximum power the person can take, and then you bring on the AM. FM together, and then you hold it there. Right, that's how you do it. So just hold it there sometimes you can ask them to kind of stretch, you know, spread the rib area. Okay, just bring back the shoulder, and then that way, it will, yeah, and this way, it will be able to kind of expose more nerve ending to the electrode of the space healer, and you may get a better result. Okay. Now, shoulder problem, shoulder tendonitis is very common. As, you know, with some athletic activity, or as we get older, in our 40s and 50s, many people develop, you know, shoulder tendonitis. Our experience shows the most common point to locate is right here, the inner part of the humeral head, right? That's where the point tends to be worse. Okay, this is the most common point. Find it, put the device over here. Alright. Again, turn on the power to the maximum the person can take, and then you go to AM FM similarly. Right? You put it there and you can rub into that joint area, or just hold still, or have the person kind of move the arm like this. Alright, that way you'll be able to cover more of the nerve ending. Expose the more of the nerve ending. Okay, good. Now, besides this point, our experience shows that it could be right in the middle, you know, close to the top part of the of the bone here, or it could be down here, right, at the lower edge of the deltoid muscle, or it could be in the back part, in the posterior edge of the deltoid muscle. Okay, and then it could be anywhere up in the shoulder here, and then very important point often missed is this point here. It's a small intestine point in acupuncture, but oftentimes again it's ouch point. You don't really need to know the acupuncture, but at least you know if you explore this area, oftentimes you'll find it. It's ouch, this where it hurts. Then again, go deep into it, go really deep into it. Now AM FMO, rub into it. We feel that our experience with the shoulder is that you know it's a very high success rate. You know we have no failure so far, if provided you know how to find the point. People can be in pain for 10, 15 years. And then one treatment will give them at least 50%. Okay, now, tennis, the elbow area, tennis elbow, oftentimes it's right in this joint. All right, first explore this. Ouch, that's where it hurts. All right, place the device over there. AM FM mode, you know, bring on the AM FM, the power on, and go like this. All right. After 2-3 minutes, you may want to try different area, you know, explore this area, and this could be here, and it could be here. All right. Let's say after treating a few spots here, you're still not getting the full relief or good enough response, then you may want to consider the back part right in here. Now, our experience has been that sometimes the pain, actually the trigger pain, is right behind here. So once you look for it, all right, you use the device and right deep into it, right, and perform 1-3 minute treatment here. For the inner part of the elbow, we call it the golf elbow area, and oftentimes the pain will be here, all right here. That's where it hurts. Then you place the device right over the area, again AM FMO, all right, or you can try a few more muscles. Or maybe you want to explore the different part of the joint space here. Again, you know, make sure it's deep, into it. For the wrist area, our experience shows that usually it's this spot here, all right? That's where the spot of pain, or it could be back here, right? Of course, it could be anywhere on the surface of the wrist joint, but oftentimes it's this area. So in this case, dig into it, dig into the joint area. Not just treat the bone, not the bone surface, but dig into this area. Or in this area. Right, dig into it, the joint area. Okay? Pain on the fingers, it could be arthritic pain, or it could be a trigger finger. Alright. Just cover the area of pain. Just you know, top, bottom, and sideways. Let's say this is the finger is the problem area. Then you just kind of try to flatten the surface. You get a good contact. Right, this is an uneven area, so you get a good contact. You know, 1 minute or 2 minutes, and then 1-2 minutes on the inner side, 1 or 2 minutes on the outer side, and then the surface. You know, the surface of the joint. That way you'll feel a relief very quickly. Alright, now, someone can have a digestive problem or gastric cramp, alright, and of course, if you can find the point of pain, look for it, alright, otherwise, just put the device over the meridian point, there are a number of them, you don't need to know exactly, so just cover the whole area, alright, anywhere here, anywhere there, And then after the point treatment, you know, a couple of minutes here, a couple of minutes there, and you can do the sweeping again. You know, just cover the whole area. Just go, go, go. Just go over the whole area. All right? If the liver area here, then you just put it over or sweep the whole liver. Right. Now, low abdominal pain, you know, could be a digestive, you know, power problem, constipation problem. Just go right into the lower abdomen. Right. For female cystitis, just go right into the pelvic bone, the pubic bone, on top of the pubic bone, and push right into it. And then it could be ovarian pain. Again, you can sweep the whole area. Right. So this is cover the abdominal area. Okay, we're going to cover the pain in the hip joint area. Oftentimes, you know, people will explain to you that they experience pain, you know, right around this area. Okay, this usually is the hip joint area. A lot of elderly people, you know, fracture the hip. But usually that means there's a lot of degenerative changes in the hip joint, and the hip joint becomes kind of roughened up, you know, it's not as smooth, you know, painful on prolonged standing or walking. Again, this is where the femur, all right, the hip joint is right here. You explore around the area, on the top of the hip joint, on the front of the hip joint, on the back of the hip joint. You really have to go deep, you know, it's a well-protected with very strong muscles and ligaments. Right, say, let's say you find this area, let's move down a little bit, okay, this is the top part, so you put the device, dig right into it, see, dig right into it. And oftentimes it could be the front part of the hip joint, you go right into this area, all right, dig into the joint area. Again, similar technique, AMFMO, you know, like this, all right, and go like this, okay, that will cover the surrounding the hip joint area. And sometimes people might feel the pain on the side of the thigh. Again, locate it. You know, if you can find the trigger point of pain, if that's where it hurt, you go for it. There could be an acupuncture point, but you don't need to know. As long as it hurt. If it doesn't hurt, you know, it's probably not useful. But when it hurt, you put right over this area, or you can sweep. And for athletic performance, before the athletic event, you might want to sweep the whole body, you know, the muscle area. Okay, now. Then we'll talk about the knee. Okay. The knee pain could be on the side for arthritic changes, sometimes rheumatoid arthritis, sometimes osteoarthritis. Now it could be right in the joint space, all right? In right in here, you'll be tender, or it could be right here, it could be tender, and it could be right on each side of the patellar bone, we call the knee eye point, all right? In here, all right, or could be just right underneath there. Could be right on top of it. Another point could be here, all right. But these are the immediate point. Then it could be a little bit, you know, farther away. That's where the muscles kind of attach to the bone. It could be down here, or it could be lower here, all right. So don't search in this area. It could be a little bit farther away. So once you find the point, again, use the AMFMO on the knee eye, on each side, wherever it hurts, or it could be in the joint space, or it could be down here. Now, a lot of people will try to just concentrate on this here and missing this point here. Now, sometimes it could be lower, all right? And you go, treat it a couple of minutes here, and then it could be lower here, all right? It could be another point, you know, it's a very important acupuncture point right in this area. It should hurt, right? The way to locate them is to put your thing here, and then the thumb area, that's where it hurt. And then, go for it. Right. So after the treatment, the person still say there is not much help, or the, you know, improvement is not significant. In that case, you probably missed the area in the back of the knee. All right. So let's go to the back of the knee. All right. This is the popliteal area. Oftentimes you find a point on both sides, on top, on each side, or it could be below here, or it could be right here, somewhere here, you know, where the small muscles are involved in the knee joint area. So again, hold the device a few minutes, couple of minutes, you know, where they hurt, right? and you go cover this area, then you will cover some of the knee point that people oftentimes miss. Particularly when people say that I don't have the strength, you know, to kneel up or down, and that oftentimes is a small muscle, you know, right in the behind the knee area. So you really try to look for it. Okay, that will cover the knee area. And then of course, you know, people might have got cramp in the calf area. You know, again, look for the point of pain. You know, press it down once you find it. You know, it could be here, it could be here, or you may want to strip the whole, you know, the whole calf area. Right, that will cover this area. Achilles pain could be down here, all right, or here, on both sides, all right, here and here. Just good contact. Most important thing is you want to aim for good contact. Of course, it could be right on top of it, right? But our experience is usually this is the important meridian point that on both sides of the Achilles tendon. All right. Now, if you sprain your ankle, it could be all swollen, bruised. Most ankle sprain comes from an inversion injury. You know, you sustain the injury like this. Of course, you torn the ligament right in this area. Right. Again, put your finger here, look for it. You know, ouch, that's where it hurts. Ouch, that's where it hurts. Ouch, that's where it hurts. Go for it. Right. Turn it on, turn it high a couple of minutes. Turn it high a couple of minutes, or it could be here. Now, because this is the foot area, oftentimes a very thicker and the drier skin. And the person might not feel the electrical stimulation as strongly as the other area. In that case, you may want to wet the area with just a wet towel, you know, just wet the skin so that you get a better conductivity. Now, if the pain could be anywhere in the toe area, just look for it and just press over here, whether it be on the top or in the bottom. Right? That's a very important kidney point, the source point, right in the base, on the anterior one third of the foot, right in the middle, and you may want to go right against this area. Right, it could be in the bottom, or it could be the heel spur, right? You go there, you know, heel spur pain, or the calcaneus spur pain, that's right here, or it can be on each side. Right, this is a very coarse skin area. Oftentimes you may have to turn the device maximum or wet the skin area.